गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग लवलीन, अक्षय, मिताली, आस्था, मंजोत, गुरनूर, जशनप्रीत सिंह, वरुण, कृपाक्षी, निमनवीर, स्मृति, आशिमा, जसकीरत, आदित्य. सो हूसोएवर नेम आई हैव कॉल्ड देयर अटेंडेंस हैज बीन मार्क्ड, हूज कैमरा इज ऑफ, देयर नेम हैज नॉट बीन कॉल्ड, इट मींस देयर अटेंडेंस विल नॉट बी मार्क्ड. Good morning, Gurnoor. Harmanpreet, good morning. Make sure your camera doesn't get off in between. There are some protocols you need to follow in your online class. Make sure to follow all those protocols. Good morning, Akshu. Good morning, Kavya. Okay, and good morning, Gurman. Fine. So first of all, as little bit discussion we have already done, that what we did in the last class, so with the help of a presentation also we are going to discuss about it, so give me a minute. Fine. So unit 3 relational database management we have started, and in this we have started with the DDL DML commands. So we have already discussed about create command. Other than these create command, we discussed about some of these commands also, but still a small recap also we will do for all these commands, so that all the students who were not able to attend the class during last lesson, they would also be able to know about it. Why I'm discussing it once again, because this topic is very, very important, and 110% it will be asked in the exams. So today we will be discussing about, once again, first of all, drop, alter, rename, truncate, and select command, and delete also and insert also we have little bit discussed about it. So once again we will be discussing about it. Many students are joining right now. Okay, fine. So if we come with the first command, which we discussed about the DDL command, that was the create command, right? So under the create command, DDL command, we were having create categories. If we see under the categories, we are having create, drop, alter, rename, and truncate. As I told you, alter and rename can be used with in conjunction also. In the combination, they can be used. Here, I will tell you today how separately also it can be used. So what is the use of these commands? These commands are used to add, remove, or modify tables within a database. So you can create a table, modify a table, remove a table also, and you can create a database also. You can remove a database also. You can modify the database also. If you're modifying the database, it means you're modifying the table inside the database. Then if we talk about create command, just to recap what we did in the create command. So create command, we all know that it is used to for creating the table, and it creates, always whenever you will use a create command, every time it will create a new table for you, fine. So different objects it is used to create, as given in your book, I think indexes, schema, views, which is not in your syllabus, so no need to go beyond that, that what is this indexes and all. Only tables are in your syllabus, so go with that only. So if you talk about the syntax, then you all have already studied about the syntax, that how a syntax is actually working. First of all, you need to use a command create table, then angular bracket. I have already told you use of angular bracket, that is the name, it will it will be placed here. I have received some of the messages, so let me check. Okay, just good morning, Vishali. Okay, so I hope this is all in your knowledge now. You're able to understand that how the syntax is being written. So, okay, so I received one in the chat box. It's really good that if you, without reminding you, you know that how to respond for yes, writing one in the chat box. So next, if we see about the next command, next example, if we see that how to use the create command. So if you see this command create table employee, employee ID is the field name, integer is the data type, as I told you that you do not need to specify the length here in the integer. We discussed about it. Employee name, char. Sorry, by mistake, I forgot to add psi length here, but length will be added here. Then age integer, city char, phone number var char, close the bracket and put semicolon. This is the way we should write the code. But if you're writing it in a single line, that is absolutely okay. Syntax should be used, should be correct for writing the code. It doesn't matter if you're writing it in a single line or if you're writing. The correct way of writing that which look a presentable also, it's this one only. So when you will write this code, the table which will be inserted in the table, that will be this, similar to this, that employee ID, employee name, age, city, and phone number. So similar table will be inserted. So all the recap we are doing for today, all these things we have already discussed. So make sure if you have any doubt in between, you ask me in the chat box, right? So let me check. Okay, only one is there. It means there is no doubt. So next we have another command about drop command also we have discussed. So drop command help us to do two things. Using the drop command, we would be able to delete the table also, and we will be able to delete the database also. Now, would you tell me, can we, if we use the drop command, what actually it deletes? Anyone, raise your hand if you want to answer. What all will be, content will be deleted, the structure will be deleted, or only content will be deleted, or only structure will be deleted? So Asta has raised her hand first. I'm giving her opportunity to speak. Yes, Asta.
Ma'am, drop command deletes the table content along with its structure.
Very good. So drop command is actually, it deletes everything. The structure also, you will not have the empty table. You will not have the content left if you're using the drop command. Even the database, suppose if we talk about the drop database and we write the name of the database here, then whatever tables will be there inside this database, suppose the database name is student, or if you take the database name is school, the name of the database is school. And under the school database, we have one table student, one table that is teachers, one table that is hostel. So all the tables will be deleted along with the database name that is school. So everything will be deleted. I hope it is clear up to this. So again, the same example is given here, drop table employee or drop database student. The same presentation I will share with you as well, so that you could also check it yourself, whatever we are discussing, right? So next, we have alter command. Alter command is there, which is used to modify the structure of the database. Now my question is this, you can see here, because what is being written here, if you want to add some columns, if you want to drop existing column means if you want to delete any column, or if you want to change the data type of column. Suppose if you have chosen a field name phone number and you have chosen the data type integer, and if you want to change the data type from integer to char or var char, then you would use the alter command. Now my question is this, the one who will raise hand first, that will get the opportunity to speak. My question is this, that can we modify the data of the table using alter command? Can we modify the data of a table using alter command? Raise your hand who would like to answer. You can write in the chat box also. So Mitali raised her hand first. So now Mitali will get the opportunity to speak.
Ma'am, yes, we can modify the data using alter command.
Okay. So you can mute yourself. Another student also raised their hand. Let me check. Who was it, student? Beta, please raise your hand. They can simply raise your hand once, because otherwise I have missed it. Kavya. Okay, Kavya. Yes, Beta.
Yes, ma'am. We can add, and we can also add new names and new columns to it by using this command.
Well, listen my question carefully. Yes, it is clearly written here. We can add the column and all. That absolutely okay. My question is this, can we work with the data also with the alter command? If I want to change the address of a person, if I want to change the phone number of a person, or if I want to change the department of an employee, such values if I want to choose, or sorry, change, would I be able to do that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Please mute yourself. Hanji Varun, you also wanted to speak something?
Ma'am, I think no. Ma'am, we cannot do this.
Absolutely correct. We cannot do.
Ma'am, because this command is used to modify the table, not the values of the table.
Table structure. It is used to modify the structure of the database or structure of the table. Right? So it is clearly, it was written clearly on the screen that we can add the column, we can delete the column, we can change the data type of the columns. I told you in previous class also, we can modify the structures. When we're talking about the structure, then we would not be able to deal with the data. That's why I asked this question. I hope it is clear to everyone. We cannot be able to change the data. We would not be able to modify the data using alter command. So let me check in the chat box. Many answers I have received. Screen is not visible. To whom screen is not visible? Please, Kavya, if it is not visible, please check your network connection. I think it is visible to everyone. Please give a thumbs up if it is visible to everyone. Okay, thank you everyone. Okay, now next example syntax is given that how it can be done. Like for example, if I want to add a new column, I was already having a few columns in my table and I want to add a new column, then I will use alter table. Here, this is the syntax. Here, the name of the table will come. Add will be the command or the keyword which will be used. Add keyword will be used, and here you will write the name of the column which you want to add, and definitely data type need to specify. Similarly, if I want to change the column name, then same alter table command will be used. Table name will come here. Change the keyword which will be used here, that is change. It is very simple. If you want to change the column name, use change keyword. If you want to add the column name, use add keyword. But it doesn't mean that whatever you want to do, you will add your own keyword. They are reserved keywords which can be used to operate or perform some functions. Old column name will come here and new column name will be here. So this is the syntax which you need to write. So now there is an example. You can see this example here. Alter table employee. Add what you want to add. I want to add a new column which is address, right? Which is address. Then I have specified the data type and then I have specified the length also, because in the CAD, in the alphanumeric data type, it is mandatory to specify the data type. So I have specified the, so it is mandatory to specify the length. So we have specified the length also. Similarly, if I want to change the field name, alter table employee, change phone number. And now phone number is old field name. If you have, if you remember, let me show you here. It is written old column name, right? And then new column name. So it is written here, change phone number. Phone number is old column name and contact details is the new column name, which will be changed from phone number to contact details. Is it okay? Is it correct? Is it fine to everyone? Are you able to understand? Smriti, Nimanvi, Harmanpreet, Akshay, Kripakshi, Arya. So I'm going to share the screen again. Right? Any doubt up to this? Okay, no doubt. So all one I have received in chat box. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Next, we have a rename command. Now rename command will be, if you want to change the table name or the database name, if you want to change, then you can use a rename command. So rename table, old table name to new table name, right? It will be, an example is given, rename table employee to EMP. So it will automatically change the name of the table. Code might be possible. You will not be asked in the exam for these command, but still, if it would be asked, you must know how to write all these command. Definitely, I will provide you this presentation so that you would you could also have written this on your notebooks as well. Nahi Varun, You will not specify the data type in the change option of alter command. Let me check. What are you asking? He is saying that we will see, we change phone number. Yes, Varun has got the correct value. Correct error he has found, that he told that in the alter command when we are using this, won't we add the data type here? If you can see here in the syntax, I have added data type, but उसको बोलो हम क्लास ले रहे हैं आप साहिल सर को कॉल कर लो साहिल कन्वर लिखा होगा उनको कॉल कर हाँ जी सो यू कैन सी हियर डेटा टाइप इज नॉट बीइंग स्पेसिफाइड हियर सो यस इट इज करेक्ट फॉर फोन नंबर इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू स्पेसिफाई इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू स्पेसिफाई द डेटा टाइप बट फॉर कॉन्टेक्ट डिटेल्स यू नीड टू स्पेसिफाई द डेटा टाइप right so thank you Varun for catching the error and we would be able to rectify हाँ जी सॉरी बेटा बट वी कैन ऐड नंबर नंबर फॉर आई कुड नॉट गेट यू हाँ जी काव्य बोलो बेटा
मैम नथिंग जस्ट आई वाज आस्किंग लाइक यू सेड नो दैट वी कैन नॉट लाइक इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी टू ऐड नंबर सो आई वाज जस्ट आस्किंग कैन वी ऐड
नंबर मींस लेंथ Number means this number.
Yes, ma'am.
This is not number. This is length. Use the correct term, length. In yes, case ma'am. Of alphanumeric data type, if you will not specify the length, by default it will be taken as 50. Fine. But it is always suggested to specify the length when you are using the alphanumeric data type, char, varchar, and all. But if you are not specify in the text data type, by default it will be 50. Right, so it is better to specify so that unnecessary space should not be or unnecessary bytes should not be occupied which are not going to be used. Okay, rename command we have already discussed. The first, next one is truncate command. About this also I have discussed with you. So all the rows from the table permanently will be deleted. All the records from a table, including all spaces allocated for the records, will be deleted. This command is same as delete command, but truncate command does not generate any rollback data. Now, what does this mean? First of all, drop and truncate command. Who will tell the difference between drop and truncate command to me? Astha raised her hand. So let me ask to Jaskirat. He, I think earlier also he raised his hand, but I was not able to ask him.
The drop command is the command which helps to delete the data as well as the structure of the table, but truncate command only deletes the data of the table.
Yes, absolutely. All the records, if we want to delete of a table, then we use the truncate command, right? Yes, and drop will delete everything, the structure also and table also. Now, one thing is written here that when we are using the delete command, it is same as truncate. Like delete also delete all the records. We have discussed about it. Delete also delete all the records. But when we are using the delete command, we have the option that we can use a where clause, which will help us to delete some of the specific records. But we cannot do this with the truncate command. Now, does not generate any rollback data means that if we have deleted something using delete command, वी कैन अंडू दैट ऑपरेशन. अंडू पता है ना हम करते हैं एमएस ऑफिस में, हम करते हैं अंडू कंट्रोल जेड करते हैं कि हाँ जो हमने लास्ट एक्शन परफॉर्म किया है वो रीडू वो अंडू हो जाए. ठीक है, सो इफ यू हैव डिलीटेड अ रिकॉर्ड यूजिंग डिलीट कमांड यू कैन अंडू दैट ऑपरेशन इफ यू आर यूजिंग डिलीट कमांड टू डिलीट सम रिकॉर्ड्स और ऑल द रिकॉर्ड्स. बट इफ यू आर यूजिंग द ट्रंकेट कमांड वंस यू हैव परफॉर्म द ऑपरेशन यू कैन नॉट ब्रिंग बैक द डेटा, दैट इज द रोल बैक डेटा. Let me check if any query is there. What is rollback? Okay, I have received some of the answers in the chat box. Tavleen has answered. Akshu is asking what is rollback data. Akshu, I think now it is clear to you what is rollback. Rollback means operations once we have performed. If you're able to undo those operations, it means we are able to roll back the data. But if you're not able to undo those operations, we are not able to roll back the data. Rollback is also one of the command in SQL that is not in your syllabus, but it is a command which is used to undo the operation being performed by the delete command. No, beta, in drop, rollback is not generated. Okay. Next, we have drop table. Again, the example is being given here. Same example is there. This we have already done. Now let's come to the DML commands, which we have already discussed, but still a small recap. SQL command that deals with manipulation of data present in the database. Now, if you want to work with the data, if you want to add the data, if you want to delete the data, if you want to modify the data, it is being done with data manipulation language. If you are able to see this last line, liberally speaking, we can consider even select statement as part of DML commands. Even select statement also, I have discussed with you that this is a DML command, right? But as in your syllabus, only DDL, DML has been discussed. But if it go with the advanced concept of SQL, then select is actually called as data query language command. So DQL, this is another we can say the category of the SQL command, but you do not need to worry about it. You will consider it under DMN only, but still, if in case it will be asked in the exam what is select is a DQL command, so you can write yes, it is a data query language command. So just an additional information, I'm telling you this. Hanji Mitali, you raise your hand, beta.
Ma'am, what is the difference between DDL command and DML command?
There is a huge difference between DDL and DML command. Now let me ask to someone from the students only that what is the difference between DDL and DML command? We have discussed about DDL also. We have discussed about DML also. So who will tell me the difference? Anyone, you can raise your hand. So very good. Varun has raised his hand. What about the other students like Ashima, Jasmine, Shiddat, Kripakshi, Jashan, Akshay, Gurnoor, Prapreet, Smriddhi, Aditya? All are here like statues. Harmanpreet also. See, you, aapko answer aata hai, nahi aata hai, at least koshish to karo, beta. Hanji, batao, beta.
Ma'am, DDL is used to modify the structure of table and DML is used to modify the data of the table.
Okay, fine. I got it, but I want more appropriate answer. Let me ask to Gurman. He did not get chance today. He is having some network issue also. Hanji Gurman.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ma'am, DDL is used to create the tables and the databases. Yes. And DML is used to insert the data into the table and the records into the table or delete the records to modify the content of the table.
Okay. Still, I want some more accurate answers. So let's, Akshu, can you please elaborate it a little bit in a simple language so that Mitali could understand?
Ma'am, do I have to give like points of differentiation?
No. In your own language, in a very simple language, you have to tell the difference between DDL and DML command. The very basic difference, first of all, tell.
Ma'am, in DDL, it affects the whole database in the table. Whereas in DML, it only affects the records, like two or more records in a database. Then, ma'am, in DDL, it is used to create a database schema, whereas in DML, it is used to manipulate the database.
Okay, it is correct, but still, I think won't be much clear. Yes, just Kirat, unmute yourself.
Ma'am, the DDL command stands for Data Description Language, which deals with the structure of the database, and DML stands for Data Manipulation Language, which deals with the manipulation of data.
So, very simple language was good. Hanji Asa, you also tell.
I also had somewhat same. We can say that DDL stands for Data Definition or Description Language, whereas DML stands for Data Manipulation Language. And DDL commands are used to create a database, tables, etc. And DML commands are used to insert, update, or delete the records or the table contents.
Okay, let's. Kavya also left. Let me ask him, then I will be back to Mitali. Haji, Kavya, unmute yourself.
Ma'am, I was also saying the definition and the sorry for full form and that one point of that.
Okay, create the data. Okay, fine, Kavya. Unmute yourself. Mitali, you unmute yourself. Were you able to understand?
Ma'am, yes, a bit, but not that.
Okay, what did you understand? Just tell me that.
Ma'am, first of all, we'll write its full form that DDL stands for Data Definition Language and DML stands for Data Manipulation Language. Then some have told that a data definition language is used to create tables and a database, whereas a DML is used to edit, insert, or delete the contents in the table.
Okay. Still, in a very simple language, if you have to write an exam, this is absolutely correct. But for your understanding that in one simple sentence, if you want to understand that what is DDL, DML, so it will be like this. Like if we talk about DDL, see, when you want to create the table, right? You have a table, suppose you're going to create a database regarding to the school, right? And in the school database, now you will be having some tables. School is the name of the database. Under school database, you have a table, student. Second table, you're having teacher. Third table, you're having hostel and so on. It means when you are creating those tables or creating a database structure, at that time you are using DDL commands. Similarly, if you want to modify the name of the table, now name of the table is student, but I want to change it as student details. So now I will use DDL command. If I want to change the data type, I will use DDL command. But if I want to work with a data empty table, which we call as the structure of the table, we have already created. Now next step will be we want to enter the data. Now, if we have to enter the data, it is very important that we use some other commands, because using DDL commands, we won't be able to add the data. We won't be able to modify the data. Now, add the data means, now see, in the student record, I want to add the information. Mitali is the name of the student. Her roll number or registration number is 36987. Her address is, for example, Busua. His phone number is 9785455. Randomly, I'm just saying. This is the number. Now, I'm going to add this data. Now, when I want to add this data, I cannot use DDL command. I will use DML command. So, I'm working with the data. Now, if I want to change the section, suppose section is also being added. Mitali's section is mentioned C, but Mitali is actually studying in section A. Now, I want to change the data section C to section A. Now, I'm changing field name. I'm changing here the data here, the information. You can take it as information which is being entered. I want to change that. Then we will use DML command. I hope it is clear to you now, Mitali. Okay. Akshu has asked that, can we say that 1 minute? No, Akshu, we cannot say that because in SQL statements, all commands are not there which can be rolled back, either DDL or DML. So we will not add this part. Yes, but if specifically has been asked for a particular command, then you can add this, right? So I have received. Okay. Next, we were talking about this DML command. I think now data query language, if the question will be asked that what is a data query language, So the language which is used to retrieve the records from the table or from the database, that is data query language, and Select is a data query language. It is termed as, it is always considered as a category of DML. But separately, if you will be asked that what is Select is a DDL or DQL command. So if it will be asked in differentiation, then you will write DQL, not DML, right? Next, we were having a few commands under DML, that is Select, which is used to query or fetch selected fields or columns from a database table. We have already done about it. You can take a screenshot. Insert, used to insert new data records or rows in the database table. This also we have done. Delete, used to remove one or more rows from the database table. If you want to delete one row only, then also we will use delete. But if you want to delete more rows, more than one row, even then we can use the delete command. Even if we want to delete all the records, similarly as we are deleting with truncate command, we can use the delete command also. But using delete command, we can roll back the operation. But using truncate command, we cannot roll back the operation. So if the question will be asked between the difference between delete and truncate command, then you can write the concept of truncate. Next, it is update command. Now it comes like, if you remember about, right now we discussed about alter command, right? Alter command was actually helping you to modify the table structure, right? But here now, DML command is helping us to modify the table data. So now instead of using alter command, if we want to modify the data, we will use update command. So that's why it is written. Used to set the value of a field or column for a particular record to a new value. If you want to change the value from a, now in this we cannot change the field name or data type. Using update command, we will not be able to change the data type. We will not be able to change the column name. We will not be able to change the table name. We will not be able to change the database name. Nothing we would be able to change. We would be able to change the information only. Like if I have entered a wrong phone number and I want to change that phone number in that record, I will use the update command. So select command syntax, just have a recap. If any doubt in this, if you have, you can ask. We have already discussed about it in both the ways. Write one in the chat box. Select command is there, column name one, column name two, from table name, where condition, then expression. I hope it is clear to everyone. It is only elaborated here. I will definitely provide you this presentation so that you would also be able to get the benefit of it. Next example is given for the select command, how it will be written. Select customer ID. So now we want customer ID, sale date, order ID, store state. From customers means table name is customers and customer ID, sale date, order ID, store state, these are the field names, right? For what is saying this, in this example, we have fetched fields such as customer ID, sale date, order ID, and store state from the customer table. Might be possible these are few columns or few fields in your table customer. Or might be possible the all are the all four columns are only available in the customer table. So another method also I have already told you that this is the one method. Now next, suppose if we want to fetch all the records from the customer's table, you want to fetch all the records here. If you see, might be possible there are some more columns were added in this customer's table, but I just want to find out the customer ID, sale date, order ID, and store date. Then you will write this structure, and otherwise you will write this one. Now if you can see select star from customer, if you see the output here, in the previous command we were having customer ID, then we were having sale ID, a sale date, store date, and order ID. But if we choose select star from customer, sale amount and sales person, these two columns are also being added here, which was not being displayed when we were using this code, because we have not specified here sales person and sale amount field in this structure. I hope it is clear. Please let me know if it is clear up to this. Okay. Now next we have command, similar command which is written in the SQL format. This is the output for this command which we written, we have written for the previous command on customer ID, sale date, order ID, store date from customers. Now you can see customer ID, sale date, order ID, and store date is only visible to us. It is only displaying this data. We are able to, using select command, we are able to hide some data. We are able to show only the data which we wanted to display. Any doubt up to this? Okay, no. Thank you. So now let's come to the next. Where clause and order by clause, I have not discussed here in this, but that they are also the part of it. Insert command. Insert into table name, column name 1, column name 2, column name 3, values, value 1, value 2, value 3, bracket, close, and semicolon. If you remember, we have discussed about it. This is the syntax, how we can write the command for inserting the data into the table, as insert command is used to add data into the table. By values, we mean the value of corresponding columns. Corresponding columns mean, if you are saying column name 1, the value 1 will be, the values will indicate that value 1 is the value for column name 1. Value 2 is the value for column name 2. Value 3 is the column name for the column name 3, and so on. See, in this, I can only tell you the syntax. If you remember the syntax, it is very easy. You need to remember the, you need to learn the syntax, then you would be able to write it very, very easily. Quickly, you would be able to write. Now, if we go with the example, insert into public.customers, this is the name of the table. Customer ID is the column 1. Sale date is the column 2. Sale amount is the column 3. Salesperson is the column 4. Store state is the column 5. Order ID is the column 6. Now further you can see 1005. Further it is written values. Then 1005 is the value for customer ID. 2019-12-12 is sale date. 4200 is sale amount. RK, that is RK Rakesh, that is the sale person. MH is the store state. Then order ID is 1007 is the order ID. Close the bracket and then put semicolon. So very simple way that it will be displayed. Now, when you will write this command, it will display you the message. If you want to see the record, then you have to choose a select command. If you want to see the record which you have entered now, then you have to use the select command. Now, if you have and you will write it in SQL interface like this, and then it will be giving you a message, the record has been inserted successfully. Now again it is given that if we have to insert values into all the fields of the database table, now here if you see, then each field name is being specified here where you want to enter the value. But you know that in all the columns of the table you have to enter the value. But then why to specify each field name? Why to show or add each field name? So rather than adding each field name, what can you do? You can simply write it, insert into customers, then values, then directly you will add the values rather than writing each field name. Here I have not specified. Here if you see here, here customer ID, sale date, sale amount, everything is being mentioned here. But if we talk about the next example, here I have only used the customers into insert into customers values, and then directly values have been inserted. This is only will be written if you want to enter the value for all the columns of a table. If you want to enter value for some specific columns, then you will not use this command. It will give you wrong message. So in this example, we have successfully inserted all the values without having to specify the field names. I hope it is clear to everyone. The last one, basically, which we have not discussed and which was pending, the syntax for writing an update statement is as follows. So you have to write in this way only. Update table name. Update is the name of the command. Update is the name of the command. Table name. Here the name of the table will come. Set. Set is a keyword which is the part of your update command. Hanji Mitali.
Ma'am, you have written update in capital letters. So is it important to write it in capital letters or we can write in small letters?
Okay. Jaskirat, do you have the same query?
Ma'am, no, I want to say that it is necessary to add the underscore okay. Between the table.
I give the answer. See, first of all, SQL is not a case sensitive language. If it is just to highlight, I have written in capital letters. If you write in lowercase letters, still it will be okay. Underscore I have added because whenever you are specifying any of the field name or the table name, you cannot put space between these two. As per the rule, you cannot give space. So if you do not allow, if you're not allowed to give any space, you can add a small dot or underscore, which is more preferable to join the space between these two words of a field name or a table name. Fine. So if I'm writing roll number, or suppose I'm writing admission number, then admission space number, I cannot add it. So I will write admission underscore number. Set column name 1 is equal to value. So I want to change here. So if you want to change the value of more than one column, the number of column you will add. Column name 1, then value 1. Column name 2, then value 2. Where condition. Now where condition will specify for which record you want to change the value. If you will not add where condition, then it will, whatever changes you will make, it will make changes for the whole table. If you want to make changes, for example, if you want to make changes for something like if you want to make the changes for a field class, right? Now for the class, we know that all the students of grade 9 have been promoted in grade 10. Now I want to change this value from all the students grade 9 to grade 10, right? Grade 9 to grade 10, when I'm saying all the in the grade 9 or grade 9 column or the grade column, I want to change the value for all the students. Then you do not need to use this where clause, right? But if you want to change only the section or only the grade for a particular student, then you will put the condition. It will be more clear with the help of example. Now, update customers. Now, name, this is the name of the customers. Set store date. Sorry, store state. Store state, DL. DL for Delhi. Store state, that is DL. That is Delhi is there. Where store state NY. So if it is taken as a keyword also, so jahan jahan par aapka NY mention hai, it should change as DL. If it does not find somewhere NY, it will not make changes for that value. So update command will help us to change the value. Now if you see this, update customers, set store date is equal to DL, where store state NY. So if In this customers table, under the store state column, wherever NY is written, replace this NY value with DL. Repeating again, using the customers table, wherever store state is given, you can store state column is given and the value is given NY, change this value from NY to DL. So that is the purpose of update command. Now let me know if it is clear to everyone or not. Update command is clear or not? Give a thumbs up. Okay, fine. So the last one command is left, which is actually we have already discussed. Just this complete lesson will include all the commands, so it will be a help for you as well. So let me check if Kavya Mani, why are you writing hi? Okay, now quickly, delete statement. We have already discussed about delete statement. If you remember right now, now you all are aware about it. Remove one or more rows from the database table. It does not delete the data records permanently. We can always perform a rollback operation to undo a select command. With delete statements, we can use the where clause for filtering specific rows. So if you will be asked, how will you filter which command will be used while you're deleting the records using for the specific rows, then we will use a where clause with the delete command. So syntax is this: delete from table name where condition. Ab ek baat yaad rakhna, agar aap yahan se karte ho na delete from table name and here you put the semicolon after name, it will delete all the record from the table, but we do not want to do that. So that's why we are putting the condition using the where clause, which will help us to delete a specific record. Now, delete from customers, that is customer is the name of the table, where store state is equal to MH. In store state column, wherever MH is written, those records should be deleted. Clear? Now, if you want to delete more records, where store state is MH and customer ID is 1001. So it means you can add more than one condition also. Delete from customers, जहां पर स्टोर से स्टेट तो एम एच है ही, लेकिन जहां पर 1001 जो है कस्टमर आई डी है, बोथ द कंडीशन शुड बी फिल्ड, ओनली देन यू शुड डिलीट द रिकॉर्ड. फाइन, सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू एवरी वन. सो इन टूडेज क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डीडीएल एंड डीएमएल कमांड्स. We discussed about the create command, drop command, alter command, rename command, truncate command, select, insert, update, and delete command. About all the commands we have discussed. Hanji Varun, you have a query?
Ma'am, how can we copy and paste the table in OpenOffice?
Copy and paste the table. I could not.
Ma'am, if you want to move the table.
So move command will be there. That is not in your syllabus. Even for the DDL, only create command is coding is there. Maximum drop. Others are rarely being asked. But just for the safety purpose, that it should not happen. You will be asked a question and you are not able to answer. That's why I have discussed about all. Right. So clear to everyone. So now fine. Let me check if any of the doubts to any of the student is there. So one, two, I was able to find somewhere. No, it is okay. Yes, so it is clear to everyone. So thank everyone to attend the class patiently. And I hope now this topic of SQL command is very, very clear to everyone. And if you would be given the question, you would be able to attend all the questions related to these questions, right? When will you please, ma'am, will you please send this table in group? This table or this PDF for presentation? Woman, unmute yourself. I will definitely share this PDF.
Yes, ma'am, this presentation.
This presentation I will share. Just let me add the select for the select statement, where clause and order by clause I need to add in this. And then I will definitely share it with you. Fine. So what I wanted to say that if you would study this topic from this PDF for the presentation, then you do not need to refer your book for this topic at least. Everything is given here, right? So thank you everyone for your attendance. I'm taking the screenshot because time is already more than enough. So whosoever is present, your attendance will definitely be marked. Okay, so fine, attendance has been taken through screenshot. Yes, Jashanpreet, that's why it is marked as absent. Thank you, everyone. I took 5 extra minutes. So now we will meet in next class and we'll continue with the next topic, right? I hope you all are aware about the syllabus for the periodic test. Okay, so this chapter, this complete chapter, whatever we would be able to complete till most probably the 10th of May, that will be syllabus of your periodic test, right? So thank you everyone. Have a nice day. Bye bye everyone. Bye everyone.